好，咁就首先今日咧，我哋第一个 topic 咧就会系讲关于系Google 点样教大家可以将你哋嘅品牌讲一啲关于系 export 嘅一啲嘅 strategy 嘅。咁我哋今日分别有三位嘅 speaker 啦，就系嚟自Google 嘅Advertising team 嗰边嘅有Adrian 啦，同埋 Adeline 咧，佢哋个主要咧就同大家会介绍关于一啲Google 嘅一啲 advertising 嘅一啲嘅 solution 啦，咁 and then 咧就會有Eunice 咧就會同我哋去分享關於係 Google Cloud 嘅嗰邊嘅一啲嘅solution 嘅，咁就事不宜遲嘅時候咧，我哋因為今日嘅 section 咧，我哋大概咧就係預一個鐘頭鬆啲，咁 and then 咧就會有啲 Q&A section。咁稍後嘅時間咧，我哋就會大家有問題嘅時候咧，可以喺 chat room 嗰度做一個發問嘅。咁我哋事不宜遲啦，不如就將第一個時間咧就交俾Adrian 同我哋去做一個分享先啦。咁有請 Google 嗰邊啊 ，Adrian 嗰度可以 share 個 screen 先，而家。
冇搣甩佢啊！唔想俾人 cut 住，見到個畫面。
Doris， 你聽唔聽到我？
我哋聽到啦，聽到清楚嘅。
OK， 我想問下你睇唔睇到個 slide 咧？
睇到，都睇到。
好啦，
好，咁啊交俾你啦，唔該曬。
好啦，歡迎大家啦，咁嚟到今日嗰、那個 join 到我哋依個今日嘅 webinar 啦，我哋 HKRMA 同埋 Google 啦，做依個講 export opportunity 喺香港啦。咁今日咧，我哋其實有三位嘅，咁我啦，Adrian 啦，我仲有兩個位同事啊。Adeline Chan 啦，同埋 Eunice 都會speak 嘅今日。咁首先我自我介紹啦，我就其實係 look after， 我係 head of agency for 依度個 Google Customer Solution 嘅。咁其實我做乜咧？係其實我係負責睇香港啲media agency 啦，就其實focus on grow 香港個 digital maturity 嘅。尤其是幫啲 agency develop 啲digital capability 啦，同埋幫啲佢啲 key client 嚟 grow 佢個 business 嘅。咁我喺 Google 已經做咗成年半啦。我嚟 Google 之前咧都有啲 retail experience 嘅，都俾翻個 background。我以前就其實喺 Puma 咧做marketing for APAC 嘅，同埋甚至乎如果講啲 products 咧，我就喺FMCG 啦，即係譬如喺強生公司啊、博士倫啊，都要做啲 retail products 嘅。咁呢個係我個 background 啦。咁陣間其他兩位同事都會交俾佢哋嗰時，佢哋會自佢哋介紹佢哋現在做緊乜嘅。好，咁我哋今日嘅 agenda 啦，咁我陣間會講一講下我哋HKRMA 同埋我哋 Google 個依個 webinar series 啦。咁講翻我哋個 export opportunity in terms of 有啲 trends 啊，同埋有啲 data 啦，我哋 sharing 啦。咁然後我同事 Adeline 會講翻少少 on how to get started with export 啦，啲一二三啊，同埋啲case study 啊，香港啲 case study 啦，咁睇下 and then after 睇下有冇啲question or discussion point 嚟嘅regarding 啲advertising 啦。咁 after 咧，咁大約四點我哋就會Eunice 我同事會講Google Cloud 嗰邊咧講翻個 embracing the digital moment， 尤其是講翻啲 search experience overseas 嘅。咁睇下我哋用 Google Cloud 咧點樣可以 enhance 呢個 experience 嘅。咁 Doris 都有輕輕地 touch on， 咁其實我哋 Google for Retail 咧其實係三個 key session 嘅。第一個 session 今日我哋係講緊一個 Go Abroad strategy 啦。第二就 session two 下個禮拜就其實 more focus on Google advertising， 就點樣 Go Abroad with the right digital marketing plan。And then session three 咧就 go abroad with the right technology， 尤其是用 Google Cloud 點樣make it more 容易啲啊 ，more efficient 啊嚟go abroad 嘅。咁我就 go into 我哋個我 share 翻啲 Google 啲唔係 share 翻我哋有啲 trends and data on export 啦。咁疫情對於香港啲 business 嚟講咧，咁其實係一個係一個好大嘅 negative impact 啦，我諗個個都有 experience 到啦。咁尤其是experience 到好多transportation cost 啊、logistics 啊、甚至乎 production 啲啲 key issues 嘅。咁依個你會睇到依個 chart 咧，我哋其實係 share 緊係最 latest 個貿發局個嗰個 data 係 Q2 嘅 data 係啱 June share 翻出嚟嘅。咁依、這個依然如果係講翻 Q1 同 Q2 啦，咁就係深產息嗰個就 Q2 個 latest result 啦，都依然都睇到都仲係好一個 challenging situation for 香港啲 business 嘅。但係好 the good thing is 我哋嗰 the next question 就話，如果我哋睇依年內咧，咁有咩 strategy 會 adopt 咧？咁除咗 adopt 啲 new product category 咧，咁好多啲business 喺香港咧，咁有36% 咧都係會 diversify 佢個 business 去 go overseas market 嘅。咁呢度你會見到我哋啱 highlight 咗綠色嗰個bar 啦，就會其實睇得到係尤其是今個 quarter 咧。係多咗人，多咗 business 係諗住go overseas 嘅 overseas market 嘅。咁尤其是而家我哋一個疫情啦，咁雖然疫情係 decrease 緊嘅，你睇到 top bar 啦，咁個 impact of COVID 係 decrease 緊嘅，都係仲有啲key challenges 嘅。依未來依6個月，咁尤其是都有個 slowdown of growth 啊，咁有。Closure of the border 啊，咁呢啲都係係一個 key challenge for 好多中小企嘅。咁 the good thing 咧，咁 during 呢個 period 啦，咁我哋發覺其實香港咧係已經 establish 自己咧 as 一個 key export economy 嚟嘅。咁由2019到即係全世界係排第八啦，而家。2020係去到第六啦，咁呢個係一個 key 增長 in terms of 一個 market position for 香港啊，咁都係一個 large export market 嚟嘅。咁你估下大家，我想問下啦，你覺得我哋今年年尾 Q4 會 reach 到幾多 total export 咧？我可以請你哋一個 chat room 嗰度 chat area 嗰度就答一答下咧。可以隨便估一估下，好，我未見到有人估，咁我就開估啦。咁依個 number 咧大到我都唔知點講，其實英文就係講翻 1 trillion 啦，咁 Q4 啦，咁又 expect 咗一個 8% year on year。growth 去到 $1.7 trillion 嘅，咁呢個係一個好大個數目嚟嘅。咁呢個都係講翻一個貿發局嗰個Patrick Lau 啦，都講翻佢during COVID 呢個 period 咧，咁我哋見到好多中小企咧都好好 resilient 嘅，尤其是佢哋 diversify 咗佢哋個 business to 去出海外嘅，尤其是用 e-commerce 啊 and digitization 嘅。咁我哋舊年年尾咧，我哋 Google 其實都做咗一個 research 嘅，叫做 Smart Digital City。咁我哋都有睇下分別中小企同埋大企業有咩分別咧？點解佢哋想去出海咧？海外做生意咧？咁個 key difference 就係，如果中小企咧係因為 e-com 咧就已經容易咗好多啦，可以用 e-com 嚟出去 export。咁同埋佢可以又增加咗佢個 profit margin 啦。And then also, 咁香港一個 market 咧，對於佢哋嚟講，或者係一個好competition 比較大啦，同埋個 market 未必夠大貨佢哋，所以就用呢啲係 key reason for 去 export 啦。咁大企業咧，佢因為個啲大企業都 competitor 都係 export 緊，所以佢都要 export。咁一樣同翻啲中小企都係一個 opportunity 去增加佢個 profit margin 啦。第三咧就其實可以 increase 翻佢個 annual growth rate， 咁有少少唔同嘅中小企同埋大企業。咁如果我睇翻啲中小企啦，咁我哋個 study 就 show 翻有成70% of 嗰啲中小企咧都係想出去 export 嘅。咁佢係如果我哋問翻佢想去幾多個 market 咧，咁我哋個 average number of markets 啦，有3嘅。咁如果大企業咧，咁其實佢哋嘅 average market 係2.4嘅，呢個 for 即係佢 question 翻佢當年舊年2021年嗰時問佢話出年即係、就是、今年嘅2020年會去幾多 market 嘅。咁如果問開，咁我哋問翻話，如果你想去出去 export 邊啲 market 咧，咁去邊啲 market 多咧？咁有個 key 有少少 key difference 咧，係中小企咧就會想去日本嘅，日本 is the number one market。And then 有東南亞啦，即係新加坡啊、泰國啊、馬拉啊，同埋英國啊、美國啊，咁呢啲係啲 key market 嘅。咁如果大企業咧，就第一排第一咧就其實係新加坡嘅，and then 日本嘅，咁其餘嗰啲都係 quite similar 嘅。咁如果我睇翻佢哋 export 咩 product 多咧，咁其實最多係 machinery 啦、electronics 啦、clothing 啦、toys 啊、jewelry 啊、timepiece 啊，咁呢啲都係呢個係貿發局嗰啲index 啦。咁我哋睇翻 Google 嗰邊咧都好有少少 similar 嘅，除咗 machinery 嗰邊。如果我哋睇翻啲 search 啦，咁 consumer search 咧，尤其是我哋retail category 咧，就會發覺咧，依年來咧其實會見到一個好大嘅增長嘅。咁尤其是上面嘅 toys and games 啦，有7% 啦，food and grocery 成14% 啦 ，and then apparel 有15% 噶。咁呢啲上頭三個search categories 嘅。咁 in terms of 人哋買呢啲消費者買咩多咧？咁其實我哋見到咧 ，toys and games 咧係增長得最多嘅。咁 second 就係consumer electronics 啦 ，and then apparel 啦 ，and then beauty and personal good 嘅。咁呢啲其實都可以拉翻我哋見得到啲 categories of 我哋啲client 嘅。咁你會問啦，咁我哋當我哋知道有咁多 opportunity、咁多 category 啊，同埋咁多中小企都係想去 export 咧，咁我哋點樣 start 咧？咁我就啱啦。而家我想交俾我個同事啦 ，Adeline 咧，就會介紹我哋點樣 start 依個 journey 啦。
Hello， 大家好，我就係叫 Adeline 啦。咁我係同 Adrian 一齊 work 嘅。Adrian 之前自己都介紹咗啦，咁佢就係幫 agents。邊去 improve 佢哋嘅 clients 嘅 digital maturity 啊 ，drive digital transformation projects 咁樣啦。咁我呢邊咧就其實係幫direct client 嘅，即係話我會特別即係直接幫個 brand， 咁就唔使經過 agency 啦。咁亦都係特別照顧 retail clients 嘅。咁所以今日我喺呢度同你哋傾偈啦，係超級 relevant 啦，咁亦都好開心可以喺呢度。咁係啦，唔使自我介紹咁耐啦。咁可能我哋就 get straight to it。我哋其實喺 Google 裏面咧，因為 export 都當然係一個好大嘅 pillar for 我哋嘅 retail clients 啦。咁頭先 Adrian 都 share 咗好多 statistics about 其實係邊一啲嘅 specific vertical 或者 industry 係對 export 最有關聯啦。咁其實我哋呢邊咧都有一個所謂嘅 export 1-2-3 framework 嘅，咁就簡化咗成個 export 嘅過程同埋 process 啦。咁又唔使多啰嗦啦，我哋快啲就講啦。其實第一個 step 咧就係都想睇下點樣辨認到唔同嘅 opportunity 啦，等我哋可以 capture 到一個市場上面嘅 demand 嘅。咁其實有啲 top of mind 嘅問題，好多我嘅 client 喺 retail 嘅世界度都會嚟問我嘅。可能係喂 Adeline， 其實邊個 market 究竟有最大嘅 potential 啊 ？for 我嘅 product， 邊個 market 其實有最少 competition 啊？我哋即係未必係最大嘅 brand， 可能係中小企，我哋都唔想即係可能同啲更大好大競爭力嘅國家去搶啦，係咪？咁其實邊啲國家又可以有更加好嘅 profit margin 咧，俾到我個 product 之類咁樣嘅 questions 嘅。咁去完呢個 stage one 之後咧，我哋都會想去plan 翻我哋個計劃啦，我哋個 go to market strategy 啦。咁其實呢一個時候都要諗翻，咦？其實我哋其他嘅競爭者喺我哋呢個 industry 裡面又有做緊啲乜嘢嘅動作啊，又或者乜嘢嘅 project 嚟到 drive 佢哋嘅呢個 market 裡面嘅 brand awareness， 甚至乎 conversion 咧。咁亦都係用啲咩 media mix 嚟到進入呢一個市場咧？因為當然每一個市場都有唔同嘅 media channels 啦，咁亦都有唔同嘅behavior 嘅 in terms of 佢哋個 user base。咁當然我哋想明白佢哋個 pricing strategy。 係應該點樣計啦，係咪？即係譬如我哋呢一個 market 其實可能個logistics cost 係平啲嘅，咁可能我哋個 pricing strategy 就有分別啦，會其他嘅 market。咁到最後啦，我哋 plan 曬所有嘢，有咗個計劃喺度啦，咁我哋就真係要進行要點樣打進新嘅市場啦。咁呢個時候就當然我哋要用翻我哋嘅 Google tools 同埋 products 嚟到去研究點樣去揼呢個 media plan 啦，係咪？究竟點樣先至可以 reach 到我哋個 customers？ 究竟點樣先可以賺到最多嘅錢？有 revenue 又係啦 ，profit 嗰邊又係啦。咁亦都點樣去 reduce 你個 cost 嚟到打我哋嘅競爭者？所以我哋先至可以喺呢個 market 度贏到我哋嘅 market share 嘅。好，咁喺呢度咧，我就去可能下一個 slide， 等大家都明白到我哋其實可以點樣用利用 Google 嚟幫助到你哋 across 呢三個 stage 嘅。咁其實呢度我都你都見到啦，我哋呢度擺咗個 Google 個 logo 喺呢度 ，show 到你哋喺其實 Google 喺邊度可以幫到你哋嘅 ，specifically 喺 ads 嗰個層面上面啦。咁其實就係即係好多客人都會問我，咦，其實你點樣可以知道我個邊個 market 有最多？potential 我個 product 啊，咁亦都我哋會睇翻，咦，其實個 search volume 為你個 product 有幾多咧？咁然而都 translate 咗 into 我哋嘅市場上面嘅 demand 嘅，因為有人揾你個 product， 咁即係就有個 demand 有個 opportunity 喺度俾你去 capture 啦。咁亦都可以睇翻，咦，其實個 ad depth 又或者 CPC 嚟講，究竟邊一個 market 比較平咧？咁又變咗我哋可以冇咁多 competition， 咁又容易啲可以即係grow 得快啲啦，咁樣。咁跟住之後，亦都會我哋計劃點樣 go to market 嘅時候咧，咁都會可能會睇翻，咦，其實其他 competitor 又係點樣噶？咁可能睇翻啲 case study， 咁我哋一陣間都會 share 翻幾個 example 俾你，點樣香港嘅 local company 去做 export 嘅。咁跟住之後，亦都會問下，咦，其實 Adeline， 我究竟應該使幾多錢啊 ？Based on 我呢個 media mix， 我可能有唔同嘅 channel 啦，有唔同嘅 behaviour 想 target 啦 ，based on 我個 audience。咁呢啲種種嘅 questions 咧 ，Google 裡面都有好多 data 可以幫你分析，而答到你呢個問題。等我哋可以 formulate 到呢一個go to market 嘅計劃啦。咁當然我哋入 market 嘅時候，即係打進市場啦，即係要 execute 嘅時候啦。咁我哋都可以用 Google 種種嘅 data 去做翻我哋嘅media plan 啦。咁而明白到我哋點樣可以 reach 到我哋嘅 customer， 去我哋嘅 target， 去 reach 我哋個 target audience， 然而 grow 到我哋嘅 revenue 啦。咁我哋喺呢度 retail 嘅世界都係為咗賺錢，係咪嚟到 grow 我哋嘅 business 啊嘛？咁其實下個禮拜之前，我知道我哋都book 咗我哋大家嘅時間，嚟緊兩個禮拜都係我哋嘅其他同事會同我哋講其他 tools 啦。咁其實喺 Google 裏面咧，我哋都有分兩種 tools 嘅，一種就係 external tools 啦。咁可能在座咁多位都會知道聽過，我哋可能有 Market Finder 啦。咁即係話亦都會幫你，咦 ？Based on 你個 website 或者 based on 你個 product， 我哋覺得以呢啲 market 咧就應該最有 demand 噶啦，咁樣。咁當然，如果我哋想 go deeper， 明白多少少點解呢個 market 啊嘅時候咧，我哋都可以問翻你個 Google account manager， 即係好似我咁樣嘅同事啦。咁就睇下，咦，其實可唔可以 deep dive 多少少個 market insight 啊？咁呢啲就係 exclusively Google account manager 可以 provide 到俾你嘅。咁好啦，去到 stage two， 我哋要計劃我哋嘅 go to market strategy 嘅時候咧，咁我哋都可以利用 external tools， Google Trends， 可能大家都有用過 trends.google.com 啦，咁就可以可能擺翻你個 product 嘅 search term 或者 keyword， 甚至乎 topic 入去，咁睇下可能點樣個 trends 喺邊度最多啊，有冇 grow 緊啊呢排，咁亦都係時間上啦，同埋geolocation 上面啦，都有到 data 話到俾你聽，咦，我哋從何而入咧？咁當然 ，again， 我哋要 deep dive 嘅時候，我哋都可以再俾多更加多嘅 search insight 俾你啦，甚至乎 CPC 啊、search demand 啊、咁樣嚟到俾翻啲 competitor benchmark， 等我哋大家可以好 plan 嘅。咁去到第三個 stage， 我哋真係打入市場啦。咁呢個時候就真係要入到我哋個 Google Ads 嘅層面度咁低啦，係咪？咁可能大家可能做過 Google App 嘅都會知道，我哋會用 Keyword Planner 啦、Reach Planner 啦同埋 Performance Planner 嚟到去。understand 我哋個市場上面究竟有幾多 demand 啦，個 CPC 係幾多啦 ，competition 係幾多啦，先至可以落 ad， 然後即係真係 reach 到我哋嗰個 customer 做到網上生意啦。咁當然我哋都要明白到我哋嘅 website 上面我哋嘅 user 嘅 behavior 由 organic 由 paid 同埋其他嘅 channel 嘅 sources 都要 analyse 一下，先至會明白你成個 market 嘅 full picture， 然後先至可以再 optimise 翻你個 campaign 啦。咁當然，我哋 Google 嘅 account manager 都可以再俾多更加多嘅 insights 俾你哋 about 你個 target audience， 等你哋可以 tap into 啲 更加前衛嘅 audience segments 啦，又或者更加 efficiently 咁樣使用你嘅 retargeting pool 嘅。好，咁其實呢一個嘅 tools 咧，可能我就等下個禮拜我兩位同事咧就同你哋傾多少少，究竟點樣用啦，同埋點樣去request for 呢種嘅 data 嘅。咁去到好啦，佢頭先我都 mention 過啦，我哋其實都會 share 翻啲 case study 俾大家嘅。咁我其後我都有之前講過啦，我係特別做 retail 嘅客嘅。咁唔知道大家有冇聽過 kickscrew.com 咧？可能都有嘅，大家。咁其實佢哋係一個香港 born and raised 嘅一個波鞋嘅 marketplace 啦。咁如果大家上網睇下 kickscrew.com 都會見到佢哋噶啦。咁啱啱上面都有好多報道，包括佢哋嘅 growth rate 啦。咁其實好快，我未播片之後之前咧，都同你講一講。其實 kickscrew 一開始咧，係喺 Google 嗰度做Google Ads， 咁亦都唔係話 globally 去做 export 嘅，就可能得幾個 market 咁樣。咁但係佢就利用咗我哋頭先所講嘅 step 1、2、3 啦，嚟到 identify 咗好多 market， 好似差唔多有40個咁多。咁然而佢哋個 revenue growth 都有 50% 嘅 growth 喎。咁所以呢一個咧就可能我唔多講啦，等我放片大家睇。
我17岁嗰时咧，就帮个朋友就排波鞋啦，排咗一晚就帮佢买一对波鞋，之后我就赚咗一个少少嘅钱啦，咁就开始咗呢个波鞋嘅行业啦。Kickscrew 咧就喺2008年嗰阵时创立啦，目的就系想全世界人咧都揾到佢自己中意嘅嘢啦。波鞋文化咧就系关于 streetwear 啦，或者系high fashion 咧又有啦。我觉得每一个人都会有佢自己想要或者喜爱嘅波鞋。头嗰十年咧，公司大约一日就卖15对鞋左右啦，咁就系卖去6个市场嘅。最麻烦就系啲顾客揾唔到我哋。咁其实嗰阵时我就Year 2就冇讀啦，就創立咗 Kickscrew 啦。咁我就都有一啲員工啦，要養啦。咁嗰陣時如果冇生意咧，嗰陣時都係一個非常之擔心嘅嘢啦。
我哋知道全世界嘅波鞋愛好者咧，都會用 Google 嚟揾關於波鞋嘅一切資訊。我哋用唔同嘅關鍵字同佢哋展示佢哋心水波鞋嘅 Google Ads， 等佢哋可以直接一撳咧就可以入到網站買到波鞋。呢個咁快咁有效率嘅購物方式咧，就充分顯示咗 Google Ads 嘅魅力。
今年啦，我哋依家大約每日生意咁係有一個50倍嘅增長啦。呢件事係一件好神奇嘅事啦。今時今日咧就賣緊超過去40個唔同嘅市場啦。咁啊，包括可能係韓國啊、泰國呢啲啦。咁遠至可能係哥斯達黎加呢啲啦。我相信冇咗 Google， 我哋今日都做唔到呢個成績。咁我覺得我作為一個土生土長嘅香港人啦，咁可以俾年輕人作為一個借鑑啦。咁其實香港做好多嘢多元化嘅都能夠成功，我哋亦都可以成為一個國際嘅品牌。
好，咁我放咗片啦。咁大家睇到呢個 Kickscrew 故事都可能會比較 impress 嘅。係咪？佢係50倍嘅生意 growth， 唔係呢度50%，寫錯咗，唔好意思。咁其實我頭先都聽到啦 ，Johnny 係個 founder 啦。咁其實都我作為一個香港人，都超級 inspire 佢呢個故事啦，係咪？咁 entrepreneurial 亦都自己起家作業咁樣。咁但係你都聽到，其實佢係即係連高斯達黎亞呢啲咁樣嘅國家都可以去 export 到嘅喎。咁呢個我覺得佢之前咧，得六個 market 嘅時候，佢過嚟問我：咦 ，Adeline， 我究竟去邊一個 market 好啊？嘅時候，我哋都冇諗過，其實我哋會有咁多個 market 係有咁大嘅 demand 嘅。咁但係 in fact 睇一睇個 data， 就真係揾到，咦，原來真係有呢一個 demand 喺度。咁做咗，咁當然就亦都有個 constant 嘅 test and learn 同埋 optimization 嘅 process 啦，令到我哋可以達到今時今日咁樣嘅成績嘅。咁所以其實呢一個都係一個我哋好 proud 嘅 story 啦。咁然而我哋而家其實都繼續同 Kickscrew 有合作嘅，咁亦都喺度諗緊點樣可以繼續去 expand 同埋 grow 佢哋個 business。咁其實我覺得呢個真係我哋 for 香港嚟講，都聽到 Johnny 頭先所講啦，係一個好好嘅 example 啦，嚟到我哋繼續慢慢創業，尤其是喺個 retail 嘅世界裏面。好，咁呢一個可能其中一個最大我哋export 嗰陣想問嘅問題咧，或者一個 retail 啦。就可能係咦，究竟去邊啲 market 好啊？去完邊啲 market， 我哋又點樣去 optimize？ 點樣去 plan 我哋個 strategy 咧？ 係咪？咁呢個係其中一個，咁用 Kick School 呢個 example 咧，就都帶到俾出嚟俾大家聽到，我哋 Google 點樣可以幫到你？咁第二最大嘅一個其中一個challenge 咧 ，for 我哋 export 咧，就係 localization 咯，即係話我哋點樣可以打入一個國家，又用翻佢哋嘅語言，又要用翻即係又 match 翻佢哋嘅 UX 嘅 behavior 咁樣嚟到行啊！咁其實呢一個我覺得 for 我哋香港人嚟講啊，都超級係 almost 係 native 㗎啦已經，因為其實我哋香港嚟講，我諗大在座咁多位都係好似我咁係 bilingual 啦，又識講英文，又識講廣東話，甚至乎可能識講普通話添，係咪？仲有更多其他嘅語言。咁其實全世界唔係淨係香港人咁叻㗎嘛，個個都識講好多語言嘅。咁 in fact 我可能呢度有幾個 statistic 可以 share 俾大家聽啦。咁其中一個咧就係、當加拿大。唔知啲加拿大人咧，其實有13% 係會講法文嘅，唔係淨係講英文嘅。咁喺以色列亦都一樣啦，其實有23% 嘅人係講英文嘅，唔係講 Hebrew 嘅。咁去到喺瑞典嗰度，亦都有12% of searches 係用英文 search， 未必係用Swedish 嚟到 search 嘅。咁其實呢個已經話到俾我哋聽，咦？我哋好多時候會唔會係缺乏咗呢一個 second language 咧 in the market？係咪？咁即係可能喺香港都一樣啦。我哋可能淨係落香港嘅中文，但係就未必會落可能簡體字啊，或者未必會落可能英文啊，或者可能其他語言咁樣。咁但係其實有可能有 demand 嘅喎，我哋可能唔知道啫，係咪？咁我哋可能講緊 export 嘅時候啦，頭先 Adrian 都有 mention 過，其實東南亞嘅國家啦、歐美啦，都係一啲超級普遍嘅國家 for 香港人去 export to 嘅。咁其實我哋諗緊歐洲嘅時候，大家都知道啦。其實歐洲人一就係講英文啦，二就係佢哋個 local language。咁其實三，因為其實都係大家係Latin 嘅 roots 啦。咁所以其實個個都會讀識得好多個 language 嘅喎。In fact， 有多過一半嘅歐洲 resident 係可以識得講多過兩個語言嘅。咁真係好叻。咁喺美國裏邊咧，都有1/5係可以 speak多個英文一個語言嘅，咁可能係西班牙話啊，可能係法文啊，可能係中文啊，咁都不得知嘅，係咪？咁最勁就可能係印度啦，咁佢哋因為好多 local languages， 咁所以其實佢哋一個國家裡面有20個 official language 嘅，咁所以變咗，如果我哋想打入呢啲嘅國家咧，我哋淨係用英文或者淨係用 local language 未必足夠，咁所以我哋去到講，咦，我哋做 ads 嘅時候應該點樣諗啊？咁呢個就係我呢個 slide 嘅 key point 啦。我哋有個 primary language 嘅 inventory， 咁我哋用加拿大嚟做 example 啦，咁可能就係英文啦。咁但係亦都有個 non-primary language 嘅 inventory， 咁即係話如果我哋想 target， 咦 Quebec 嘅人咁樣，咦一定要做法文喎，又因為佢哋可能嗰邊係講多啲法文唔係講英文嘅喎。咁呢個未必係對我哋一個 export 嘅人，香港人，我哋對嗰個國家冇咁認識嘅時候，就未必知道。咁呢個我哋點樣可以make sure 我哋 mitigate 咗呢個 challenge 咧，咁都可以我哋 basically 用翻 data 去verify 我哋嘅諗法嘅。咁頭先呢度大家記住啦，用加拿大嚟做 example， 我哋有13% of 所有嘅 searches 都係喺用法文嘅，唔係用英文嘅。咁但係你哋又諗下，咦？咁 advertisers 咧，我哋落 ad 嘅時候，我哋有幾多 percent 係落喺英文 ad， 有幾多 percent 係落喺法文嘅 ad 咧？好啦，我開股啦喎。咁其實咧，喺加拿大嘅 domestic advertiser， 即係話我係加拿大人，我喺加拿大落廣告，咁佢當然就最認識呢一個 market 啦，佢自己一個 market 嚟噶嘛 ，home country。原來喺嗰度嘅人咧，係會invest 13% of 佢哋嘅 ad budget 喺法文嘅，咁其餘就係可能大多數都係英文啦，咁亦都可能有啲中文或者 Maltese 咁樣嘅。咁但係呢一個亦都反映咗我哋有13% 頭先話 of searches 喺加拿大係繁穩喎，咁咪有相應咯。好啦，我哋睇翻我哋Greater China 啦，咁即係中港台啦，係咪？我哋喺呢度嘅 targeting， 如果我哋想 export 過去嘅時候，我哋有冇呢個對應咧？係咪？我哋有冇睇翻個 data 有幾多 search volume 係其實係繁穩嘅咧？原來就冇咯，其實得3%，差唔多4%啦，3.8%。of advertising budget 係擺喺法文嘅，如果係 for 香港 export 過去嘅 clients， 咁如果係咁樣諗嘅話，即係話我哋香港嗰邊或者 Greater China 嗰邊做 export 嘅時候，其實有差唔多10% 個 gap 我哋係冇 address 到嘅喎，係咪？即係話10% 嘅講法文嘅人其實係想買你個 product， 但係我哋 show 唔到個 ad 俾佢，因為我哋冇睇翻個 data 去明白到呢一個 advertiser 或者我哋個 export country 究竟個 localization need 喺邊度。咁呢個就都想提醒翻各位係要留意翻啦 ，in terms of language 亦都唔好 limit 得太多。我哋個其中一個 language 都行，因為咁樣就變咗 narrow 咗你個 audience 啦。好，咁而家又係故事時間啦。我諗大家都聽過 Casetify 呢一個 brand 啦。其實我呢度咧都係一個大用者嚟嘅 ，Casetify 有電話繩啦，好似90年代興完之後，而家又再興翻啦，係咪？咁所以變咗咧 ，Casetify 一個好大嘅 local 香港嘅 exporter， 其實佢係一個 global brand， 其實大家都知道噶，但係佢個 headquarter 喺香港嘅。咁佢 global brand headquarter 喺香港，佢點樣做咁多個 export 啊？咁呢度咁多字，可能我就簡單 summarize 翻俾大家啦，係咪？呢一個 Casetify 嘅 brand， 佢不嬲都係眼睇住個 export opportunity， 究竟去邊一個國家好嘅？亦都一路有 export 緊，亦都所以有一路 data 入嚟，知道咦，其實泰國好有 demand 喎。過去泰國我哋做 smart shopping 嘅時候，哇，有好好嘅 revenue 入到嚟，亦都有個好好嘅 ROI 喎。咁其實我點樣可以用最容易嘅方法去繼續 grow 呢一個市場咧？因為泰文都有少少難度啦，我哋條 team 又得一條 team 喺香港，未必有人識講泰文喎，係咪？咁點算啊？咁其實佢呢個都超級 smart 好 efficient 咁樣揾翻 Google 就睇下，咦，我哋有啲乜嘢 automated 嘅 product， 其實係可以幫我哋搞掂咗呢個 localization 呢件事咧。咁我哋咪唔使揼可能20個 banner、100個 banner， 我哋可能就擺幾個 asset 入去，佢就自己 responsively 用 automation AI 咁樣砌咗出嚟俾你。咁其實佢哋做咗呢一樣嘢咧，就用咗我哋嘅 Performance Max campaign。咁亦都利用我哋唔同嘅 asset group 啦，令到佢哋好容易咁樣，令到automation 幫佢哋做曬所有嘅 heavy localization work。咁然而亦都變咗佢哋可以 scale 咁樣喺泰國度展示佢哋嘅brand 嘅好嘢啦，係咪？所有嘅unique selling point 都出曬嚟啦，亦都加咗一個 product fee， 等佢哋個 product 嘅category 同埋 color inventory 咧係俾到泰國人去睇嘅。咁 match 翻佢哋個泰文 landing page 咧。大家都見到佢哋個 results 啦，其實個 conversion rate 係高咗差唔多3倍咁多啦。咁 CPA 即係個 cost per acquisition、cost per purchase 咧係少咗68% 嘅。咁呢一個係一個好驚人嘅results 啦。咁當然就 improve 咗好多啦。咁其實就可以有 show 到，咦，我哋唔單止去 identify 究竟邊一個國家、邊一個 market 我哋去 export 去係會對我哋更加有好處啦。第二，亦都係會明白到，咦，我哋點樣計劃去進入呢個 market 咧？但係第三，我哋進入咗之後，我哋都一路要繼續去 test and learn， 令到我哋可以收到嘅回報更加好，一路都喺度 improve 緊嘅。好，咁我喺呢度咧就係、是、想 open up 睇下大家有冇啲其他嘅問題啦 ，about 之前嗰兩個case study share 咗 about pickcrew.com 同埋 about Casetify 啦，或者頭先 Adrian 所 share 嘅咁多唔同嘅 export trends。有冇啲其他嘅問題想發問一下咧？好，咁開翻個 chat box 先。
唔該曬 Adeline 同埋 Adrian 啊！大家如果有啲咩問題想問咧，可以，如果你想開麥可以開麥問啦，亦都可以喺個 chat room 度問嘅。Any other cases？ 我見到啊 ，Tony Lam 有個問題， oh. 有冇其他嘅 cases 可以 share 咧？
可以啊，其實這個呢一個咧，我諗 depending on 你其實個retail 係賣咩 product 啦，咁我哋當然你可以問翻你個 Google Account Manager， 遲啲可以補翻係啱你個 vertical， 又或者啱你個 market 啦，係咪？或者啱你想用嗰個 Google product 啦，嚟到俾翻一個 case study 你 show 翻俾你，其實係想點樣用咯？因為我覺得我哋即係當然最 customize 嘅 case study 可以 show 到俾你睇點樣做 proof of concept 先至最有用啦。Is there a link from Google on cases？ 呢一個係冇嘅，一定係要問翻我哋 Google account manager share 翻俾你嘅。不過我哋當然可以去 thinkwithgoogle.com 嗰度，其實有啲 published 嘅case studies 你可以參考一下嘅都。咁嗰啲就係係啦 externalize 嘅。
My website is only written in English or Chinese. How can other foreign language people see your website and buy products?
咁呢一個其實咧就有兩個 way 嘅。如果你個 website 係淨係英文同中文咧，咁呢個 OK。我哋當然就係一定要有英文同埋中文嘅 ads 啦。 咁但係我哋第二個 stage 就可能會落翻啲誒，當如果你要去泰國咁樣啦，咁你可能就會 drive 個泰文咁樣啦，咁你就會 test 下，咦，究竟佢有冇 demand 啊？個 CTR 好唔好啊？咁如果好似 Casetify 咁樣一樣，哇，好好喎個效果，咁變咗佢就會直情係 translate 翻佢哋個 website， 即係多一個 language 咁嚟到去追呢一個 market， 咁都有 test and learn 嘅。呢個係其一。有另外一個 way 咧，就係、是、咦，你個 website 得英文同埋中文，咁唔緊要，香港有幾多國家？唔 sorry。全世界有幾多個國家其實都會講英文咧？咁呢一個可能就係我哋要去 test， 咦，求實其實邊一個國家對你個 brand 對你個 product 係最有關聯嘅，最有 relevance， 亦都帶俾你最多嘅 revenue 或者最高嘅 conversion rate 啦。咁 with that， 我哋先至會再進一步去 invest 去 localize 你成個 website 嘅。但係第一步就用 ads 去試下先咯。
嗯。
好。湯淵蘭同埋 Cassandra 有冇 follow up 咧？頭先答咗你兩條問題之後，又或者其他人可以 unmute 去問啊？又或者 Adrian 有冇補充？
我可以講翻咧，陣間我哋 at the end 咧有個 QR code 咧，你可以 scan 咗，就我哋即係留低你啲資料，我哋可以再 follow up 啦，睇你個 business 係咩 type of business 啊？咁我哋睇下會揾翻個同事睇下 follow up 個 category 啊。咁睇下俾啲relevant 啲個 case study 啊，我再傾一傾下。
嗯，仲有一條問題。
Mentor help us find out which country people like our products。咁呢個係market finder 可以幫你 work out 邊啲market 啦，咁同埋睇下嗰個國家中意咩 product。
咁呢一個下個禮拜咧 ，Steven 同埋 Winnie 我哋兩位同事咧都會再 deep dive 去 show 你究竟點樣用 Market Finder， 同埋會俾翻個 example 去 show 翻俾你哋睇，係咦，我哋 Google 如果俾 exclusive insights 嗰啲，咁又可以去到幾 deep 咧？究竟係咪幾 in depth 咧？嗰啲 data 咁樣咯。
嗯，
康遠咧，我 OK， 我哋跟住我個 LinkedIn， 我會咯。
好。
Will Google help us translate our ads into other languages? Yes, I'm very happy because Andy, 你問呢個問題啦。其實我哋 Google Ads 裏面咧，又係 through 你個 account manager， 你有個特別嘅value add 係幫你做 campaign translation 嘅。咁即係話，如果你喺個 Google Ads 個 account 裏面已經有英文或者中文嘅 ad copy 啦、site link 啦、extension 啦、keywords targeting 啦，所有呢啲咁嘅你個 campaign 裏面嘅音嘅moving parts 啦，全部都會幫你 translate 翻去你個language 嘅。咁你亦都可以同佢講話，咦，其實我想你 translate 得 casual 啲啦，或者書面語啲啦，咁樣全部都可以講翻喺度。咁我哋條 team 有呢個 reference 咯。
嗯，
有冇其他問題咧？Is there a call?How do shoppers know what local adapted language should they use in their ads or website copywriting? Okay, I'll answer Ezra first. 其實咧，個shoppers 其實唔會話知道你有邊啲 language 係應該用嘅。Shopper 其實就係我係買嘢嗰個啊，咁我講中文，我就 search 中文，咁我就會去到達到你個 landing page 中文啦，係咪？咁但係如果你其實做 market research 喺頭先我講緊 stage two 我哋嗰個 one two three step 嗰度咧，我哋做緊個 go to market strategy 嘅時候咧，咁呢個就係我哋會睇下，咦，其實呢個 local market 當加拿大咁咯，其實啲人係講咩文嘅咧，係咪？咁呢個我哋亦都可以用translate.google.com 去 uncover 啦，又或者問翻你個 account manager 攞翻我哋 Google internal 嘅 data 去 share 翻俾你嘅。好，咁睇下有冇 follow up to 呢一條問題啦。咁 in the meantime 我就再答翻 Cassandra 啦。Will the talk next week teach us how to translate our ads to other languages? Yes, Campaign Translator 係一個我哋 Google 嘅 internal tool。咁其實如果你要 access 嘅話咧，咁你都可以問翻你個 account manager 啦。咁如果你冇 account manager 嘅話咧，都唔緊要。咁我哋都可以follow up 翻喺個QR code 呢個 session 完咗之後咧，你去填翻個 form 啦。咁我哋就會 assign 翻一位同事去幫你手噶啦。好嘢，多謝 Cassandra。
好。
咁喺呢度，如果我 pass 去 Unis 嗰度咧，我都想 去提醒大家記住一間要填翻個 form， 因為填翻個 form 之後咧，我哋有翻啲嘅 feedback 啦，明白咗我哋邊度可以做得更加好啦，應該可以 share 多啲其他邊啲嘅 information 俾大家啦。咁亦都之後可能會有 assign 到個 account manager 俾你哋，等你哋可以 access 到呢啲咁正嘅 information 同埋 data 嘅。
嗯，好。唔該曬 ，Adeline， 係啦，咁啊提一提大家，咁 at the end of 呢、這、一個今日呢個 section 之後咧，我哋會佢哋有一個 QR code 俾大家 scan 翻去填翻張 form， 咁其實 RMA 咧都會喺之後嘅時間咧都會 send 翻一個 link 俾大家去填翻嗰度嗰啲資料嘅，咁同埋我見到有啲朋友仔就遲咗先入嚟啊，咁可能有啲前面嗰個 section 嘅時候都 miss out 咗嘅話咧，咁我哋都會有一個今日嘅嗰個 Zoom 咧都會 share 翻俾大家，咁大家可以重温翻，因為其實都補充翻今日呢個 section 咧，我哋係會 from 一個 overview 嘅形式會多啲嘢，咁所以一啲比較 in depth 到關於頭先我見到大家啲問題咧，都多係比較 on 一啲講緊係一啲比較 practical 啲嘅問題嘅，咁所以嚟緊 下兩個星期咧，嗰度嗰啲介紹咧就會 more on 一啲比較 hands on 嘅一啲Google 嘅 solution 俾咗大家，咁所以大家填翻咗 form 嘅時候，入邊有啲位置其實可以填翻，就有啲咩譬如可能想喺嚟緊嘅一啲嘅 section 嘅時候都想知道會多啲分享嘅話，咁可以其實喺嗰個 form 度都可以俾到啲 information 嘅，咁 Google 嗰度佢哋會稍後嗰個 section 嗰度都會解答翻大家啦，可以好。咁就係啦，咁我同時都 send 咗大家見到一條 link 喺嗰個 chat room 度。咁如果大家有興趣，而家方便時間可以聽，咁同埋其實稍後我哋仲有一個 section 嘅，仲有 Unis 嗰個 Google Cloud 嗰個 section 嘅。咁因為都會 overall 問翻大家啲意見。咁如果大家暫時對於頭先兩位 speaker 嗰度冇其他問題，或者我哋 Adeline 都仲有個 Q&A section， 大家都想問翻都可以嘅。咁我哋就不如事不宜遲，而家 Adeline 嗰度可以交個時間俾阿 Unis 嗰度可以做一個分享啦。
好，Hello， 各位好。
鏡頭一轉就交俾 Unis 啦。
交咗俾我啦，咁就 thank you 先。好嘅，咁我哋 move on 啦喎。咁點解我今日喺雲雲嘅Google Cloud 嘅 technology 裏邊揀咗依個 topic 咧，即係 embracing the digital moment。其中一個最主要原因咧，就係其實頭先兩位同事Adrian 同 Adeline 都講咗好多。其實我哋進入一個expert 嘅世界，我哋做好多功夫，即係有三個唔同嘅 stage 要做唔同嘅 research 去 make sure， 其實我哋 enter 某一個 market 嘅時候，其實可以攞到最好嘅回收。做完呢件事之後咧，其實有一個狀況咧，就係我哋點樣 make sure？當個 consumer 去到你嘅 properties， 你嘅 website 又好，你嘅 app 都好，點樣可以 ensure 佢有一個好嘅 experience 咧？當你喺前端做咗咁多功夫 ，research 做 ad 做好多功夫之後，其實佢入到嚟，如果好大嘅 disappointment， 其實都係一個浪費嚟嘅。最終大家想做到嘅嘢就係去 convert 嗰、那個那個 lead into 一個真係嘅 conversion transaction 啫嘛。咁所以揀呢個 topic 嘅原因就係、想做兩件事，第一件事就係想分享一啲 insight 啦，第二件事就係希望提供一啲快捷嘅quick solutions 去幫到大家解決一啲你哋 practically 會面對嘅狀況。譬如頭先大家都 mention 過，language 係一個好大嘅 topic 嚟嘅喎。Google Translate 係咪？大家都好熟悉啦。咁其實你都可以 leverage 我哋 Google Translate。放你個 website、你嘅 app 等等呢啲，咁所以我希望帶到一啲即係 quick 嘅 solutions 嘅 overview 俾大家知道，其實 trend 係點，其實有啲咩技術你可以 leverage 到快，你就可以做好啲你嘅成個digital experience。好啦，咁我估唔需要多講，就係大家都知道 digital 係一個好 increasing trend， 一個好 positive 嘅一個channel 去幫大家去拓展市場啦，亦都係每一個即係依家好多地方嘅人都會 leverage digital 嘅 experience 去買嘢又好，揾 information 都好。依一個期望係好高嘅。比起可能好幾年前，你嘅 properties、你嘅 website 又好，你嘅 app 都好，如果個 experience 麻麻地咧，其實嗰個大家 consumer 對於你嘅耐性咧係會有多啲嘅。但係今時今日，因為大家都做咗一個好好嘅 foundations， 亦都好適應咗依個 digital world， 所以consumer 有一個好大嘅 expectations 啊，我點樣做？我會 expect 有啲咩 expectations 啊？有三方面嘅，第一個方面就係好多時候你去到，我估大家都會有唔同嘅經驗啦。 有時會覺得啊 ，landing 去某一個 page 度，其實佢都唔知道我想揾乜嘅。佢彈出嚟嘅嘢或者佢 show 出嚟嘅 result 並唔係我嘅期望。依個係第一個反應。而我哋見到其實依一個係一個好重要嘅課題嚟嘅。第二個範疇咧就係、原來我哋冇 optimize 成個 experience。其實兩個 out of 三個嘅 consumer 都會期望啲 website 係有 personalized 嘅 experience 嘅。依、這個都幾有趣嘅一個 expectations 啦，即係其實你第一次去個 website， 其實佢都 expect 你知道我諗乜，你知道我想揾乜 ，so that 你可以 surface 到好好嘅 relevant 嘅 product 俾我。第三個範疇比較 alarming 啲嘅，就係如果你做唔好依件事咧，喺成個 search experience 裏邊，其實有33% 嘅 shoppers 係會走咗去 Amazon 或者阿里巴巴依啲好大嘅 marketplace 去揾你嘅 product。咁對於你嚟講，其實你前期做咗咁多功夫，去引啲客嚟到你個 properties 你嘅 site 之後，一個做得唔好嘅 search experience 會令到佢哋有一個即係。並做唔到我哋想要嘅 conversions。咁有咩解決方法咧？咩叫好？咩叫唔好咧？唔好嘅就係、是、啊，當喺個 app 度，我要揾依個爛爛地嘅高腰牛仔褲好貼身嘅，喺你個 site 度揾唔到，係咪？咁依個 search 本身其實係包含咗好多東西嘅，係包含咗一個好 natural language 啦，同埋好大堆嘅 keywords 啦。好多時如果你在傳統的技術你要做到這件事，其實你要做很多 tagging， 你要將 product classify 得很好。但是今天即其實什麼叫好的 experience， 就是我找到這件事，我用一個最 natural user 最 natural 的方法去 surface 到你的 product from 你的 properties。 這些數字我自己看下去其實都挺嚇人的，幾驚人的原因咧，就係、是、其實 search result 唔 relevant 呢件事咧係好常見。而其實而依個 search 嘅表現咧，係會令到你嘅customer 或者 shoppers 咧，係對於你個 brand 啊，即係你個 branding 啊，唔係淨係講緊一個 customer experience， 係講緊成個 branding 咧，係會有一個好唔同嘅睇法嘅。而70% 嘅人咧，係會唔會？再去你的 website 度，你可以想象依件事做得不好的話，其實那個 impression 令到往後呢些 shoppers 你的 target audience 的 behavior 會有一啲 change。好啦，咁Google 做 search 起家啦，咁我哋用我哋嘅 search 嘅 AI technology， 其實我哋都諗下點樣可以 leverage 咗啲 technology 幫到。大家去做好啲你哋嘅 digital 嘅生意咧，咁我哋有唔同嘅產品或者 solutions 去做呢件事。我今天會揀約略介紹一下頭兩款啦 ，retail search 同埋recommendations。咁咩叫 retail search 啊？好簡單嘅啫，就係揾嘢咯，係啦。咁點揾嘢咧？其實你如果 recall 翻自己嘅search experience， 或者你去買一件嘢嘅 experience。好簡單地就係你一係就心儀有一個 site， 咁你就走入去喺佢度 search 啦。咁依一個 on-site discovery 就係講緊依件事情啦，就係、是、啊我入到去某一個 website 上邊揾我想要嘅嘢。依度嘅例子就係 coffee maker。咁自自然然就係翻返去頭先嗰個 scenario， 就有冇辦法 surface 到啱？嘅第一啱嘅 result 啦，第二就係一啲 recommendations 喺呢個 site 上面。第二個 behavior 就係去 Google search 啦，係咪？依個我相信亦都係我哋今天好多唔同嘅 market 都會發生嘅一件事。咁個expectations 亦都會有一啲分別，就係、是、啊會唔會有辦法做到image search？我見到啊，我上早兩個禮拜去食飯，見到嗰間餐廳台面有一眼燈，好靚啊！我想買，咁我哋有冇辦法用一個 image search 嘅方法去揾到依件產品，或者 voice 等等依啲嘅途徑？咁依兩件事就係講緊 product search。咁個起始點有兩個啦，一個係你嘅 properties， 一個係一個即係 Google generic 嘅一個 search。為什麼我們做得好一點呢？為什麼我們想幫 retailers 去 喺尤其是喺 export 嘅世界，可以將呢件事做得好咧？就係我哋糅合咗咧，我哋自己 search capability 啦，左邊嘅 search capability 啦，同埋你嘅 product catalog， 因為你實會有你嘅product catalog 喺你嘅唔同嘅 properties 嗰度嘅。咁我哋就運用幾個好重要嘅元素，去令到呢個 search 做得好。第一就係understand 個 query， 好似頭先個牛仔褲嘅example 咁樣。我哋有冇辦法可以用你 basic 你嘅 product catalog 就可以 understand 呢個 query 咧？第二就係 semantic 啦，就係一啲好 natural language 嘅一啲experience 啦。同埋呢件事係我哋可以improve over time 嘅，因為其實背後 backup by Google search 嘅 AI machine learning 喺背後。所以其實一路我哋會喺背後幫你去做一個optimizations， 令到依個 experience 唔係一個 rule base， 唔係話我咁樣 search 就有依個結果，而係可以更加貼近喺你嘅 user 嘅 experience 裏邊。第四樣嘢亦都好緊要，尤其是你去到譬如歐洲嘅 market， privacy 係一個好重要嘅課題。有 Google 呢一個 technology 背後，其實你可以有一個好comprehensive 嘅一個privacy 嘅backup， 因為我哋做出嚟依個產品一定係compliant to 一啲唔同嘅地方嘅 regulations， EU 又好或者其他嘅我哋 available 依個 product 嘅locations。好啦，咁當你嘅 product category、你嘅 pricing 啊、你嘅等等嘅一啲譬如 optimization goal 已經放咗入去之後咧，我哋就可以 surface 到你喺你嘅自己嘅 properties 頭先講嘅 onsite 上面做到 search 啦。我哋亦都去 empower 到 voice search、image search、text search， 咁變咗你做一件簡單嘅事情之後咧，你就可以有 multiple 嘅 entry point。And 你可以 enjoy 到咧，喺依個 search experience 可以提供一個好快同埋好貼心嘅一個search experience。咁頭先講嗰啲，譬如係啦，即係啲audience 會離開你個site啊，希望盡量透過咁樣嘅一個好簡單嘅 tooling 咧，就幫到你去解決。我哋唔會做 demo 嘅咧，因為咧個 demo 好簡單嘅。如果你自己上到去macy.com 咧。其實 Macy 就正正係用緊依一個依個 product search 嘅technology 去做佢嘅喺佢個 website 裏邊，咁所以依一個好好嘅 example 讓大家知道啊，其實都可以好簡單因為當大家去做 export， 你可能未必係一個十個 SKU 嘅網站，你可能係一個好多 SKU 嘅一個平台，點樣去令到依件事 scalable？同埋efficient 咧，依個我哋依個 solution 所以幫到大家手咯。好啦 ，recommendations 我估講咗好多年嘅，打從有 e-commerce， 大家都話要做 recommendations 嘅。咁事實上，依件事情嗰個關鍵位咧，就係點樣 at scale。頭先譬如Adeline 都分享過一啲 use case， 由將嗰、那個traffic 或者個 business 增長50倍，你究竟個 solutions 係咪可以 support 到一個50倍嘅 traffic 咧？而 recommendation at scale 依件事就顯得重要啦。點樣可以透過一啲完全你唔需要 manage 嘅 solutions， 我哋去幫大家手去 manage 到依個 recommendations for 你可以想象，當你有好多件貨，當你有好多 customer portfolio 嘅時候，依、這個 matching 或者依個 recommendations at scale 就會發生咯。係啦，咁我哋依件事好 straightforward 嘅啫，就係同頭先 similarly 同頭先describe 嗰個情況差唔多啦。乜嘢叫做一個好或者唔好嘅 recommendations 咧？我哋有四個喺依幅 chart 嘅最底下有四個 criteria 嘅如果比較傳統嘅做法，就係用 popularity 嘅方法去做呢件事啦，即係話越多人睇，我咪會越多 surface 呢件 product 出嚟咯，係啦，或者可唔可以做 cross selling 嘅？ 譬如如果喺傳統嘅 recommendation 上面 rule base 嘅，我買一條裙，我就指明我要買第啲顏色，我 recommend 第啲顏色等等呢啲 use case 啊。可唔可以 incorporate 到其他嘅 user insight？ 依個都係一個好關鍵嘅東西，即係話類似 look alike 咁樣嘅concept 啦，就係我依個shoppers 嘅 portfolio 如果 match with 另一個 shopper 嘅 portfolio， 我應該 surface 啲乜嘢 product 出去。最尾就係可唔可以去到一個 individual level， 係一個 group 嘅 level 嘅 recommendations 啊，定話一個 individual 嘅personalizations？咁喺我頭先講，即係 Google 依個 solutions 底下，其實我哋嘅 personalizations 就係會有無論喺個 popularity， 我哋會 consider 啦，一啲 cross selling 嘅 rule 或者 cross selling 嘅一啲 criteria， 我哋會 consider 啦，亦都可以加入到一啲即係 user 嘅 insight， 亦都可以做到一個personalized individual 嘅 level， instead of 一個 group 嘅 level， 去做依個 recommendations。你會問其實咁樣會唔會好複雜，好要用好多時間做啊？頭先一開始都話其實成個 experience 我哋希望係一個好一個 quick win 啦，亦都可以好快幫你哋去 enable 到依件事嘅。有三部曲嘅，即係頭先 Adeline 有三部曲，我哋喺個 recommendation 嘅世界裏邊都有三部曲。依三部曲包括就係、如果你已經有你嘅website， 你有你嘅 online store， 其實我哋只需要你個 product。catalog 啦，同埋一啲如果你係用緊譬如Google 嘅其他 technology、tech manager 又好 ，merchant center 都好，其實我哋只需要兩個星期左右咧，就可以將依啲 data 放翻落去我哋依個 recommendations 嘅 solutions 度。如果你用緊其他 technology 嘅，可能多兩個星期去令到依啲 data import 到入去，咁我哋就開始可以進入第二個部分。咁第二個部分係做乜咧？就係、是我哋就係會做個 model training 啦。因為其實每一個 site、每一個 customer 嘅 portfolio、每一個 product catalog 都會有唔同嘅behavior 或者佢哋中意嘅東西。咁所以喺第二個部分，我哋就會用一啲時間，可能係幾日，可能 maximum 一個星期，我哋就會去做一個model training， 去 train 個AI model 話俾佢聽，其實乜嘢叫做成功。我哋想 optimize for 乜嘢？我哋想 optimize cross selling， 我哋想optimize 個wallet 個錢等等咁我哋就會做一個 training。第三就係將依一個recommendations 放喺你個website app 等等唔同嘅 channel 裏邊。咁呢啲都係一啲即係大概可能你諗緊嘅都係一個一個月兩個月嘅時間就可以enable 到一個 recommendations 嘅 capability。好，咁最尾都想即係 share 一個即係 use case 啦，而依個正正就係透過 recommendations 我哋唔係純粹為咗 recommendations， 我哋 recommendations 背後其實有business goal 我哋想 achieve 嘅，包括怎樣可以 display 到一些很 relevant 的recommendations 的 items 啦，喺個 page 度啦。喺而家依一個 case 咧，而家 IKEA 依個 case 咧，佢哋有一個 400% 嘅 incremental。Click through rate 都係一個好重要嘅 measurement， 即究竟你 display 咗依啲嘅 recommendation 出嚟之後，其實係咪真係帶到去一個佢會 click， 佢會繼續去 browse 依啲嘅 product。第三個範疇我哋 evaluate 嘅就係個 value 啦，就係 completion conversions 依個部分。咁所以喺唔同嘅 area， 其實透過一個咁 handy 嘅 solutions， 我哋都可以 bring 到一個 value to retailer。好啦，講咗依兩個唔同嘅solutions product 啦，講咗即係一個點解我哋要做依件事啦。咁最尾就想 summarize 翻，其實喺成個 digital 嘅context 底下，其實係 search 一個我哋要把關得好好嘅環節。因為頭先我哋都講過，我哋會 lost 咗成個 funnel 底下嘅engagement， 我哋嘅 audience 啊。如果做得唔好嘅話，亦都會有一個 brand 嘅 impressions 嘅 negative 嘅 effect。咁所以其實依一件事情係關鍵亦都重要嘅。我哋可以透過一啲唔同嘅 Google 嘅 technology。今日只係即係簡單介紹咗兩個好 straightforward 好但係好 high value 嘅 solutions。但係其實我哋都有其他 technology 可以幫到大家手嘅。喺你嘅 properties 裏邊，譬如話點樣去 improve 你哋個site 嘅 response。我唔知道大家有冇試過，有一啲 website 咧，你 search 完撳入去之後咧，等，一路都開唔到。依啲係一啲好 fundamental 嘅技術嘅考慮啦。咁你可以想象依個 experience， 你喺譬如 YouTube 你好少會經歷嘅。因為其實喺 Google 嘅世界裏邊，我哋有我哋嘅全球嘅海底光纖嘅 transportations 嘅網絡。即係你嘅 data 咧，其實係會喺 Google 自己 internal 個網絡裏邊咧 serve 你俾你哋嘅客嘅。咁變咗，其實我哋可以 ensure 到一個好好嘅response time， 將你嘅 website 嘅 content 好快 deliver 到俾你嘅audience。依個係其中一個啦。譬如話頭先我哋提到好多大家亦都關心嘅就 language 啦。我哋有唔同嘅to C 嘅客啦，譬如 for example Cloak 係我哋一個 reference， 佢係會用 Google Translate 嘅 API 去 translate 佢 website 嘅 content 嘅，令到佢可以喺一個成個 geo expansion 一個 export 嘅角度嚟講，佢可以好容易將佢嘅 content available for 唔同嘅 language 嘅 audience。另外譬如話chatbot 啦。如果你是做售後的，其實很多時候我們看到很多retailers， 當生意做得好的時候，售後是很艱巨的，很艱巨就是因為我生意好嘛，自然有很多 inquiry 在這裡，那我是不是隨著我生意的增長，我就按比例地增長我的售後服務的人員呢？這個似乎不是一個最理想的狀況啦。那我們其實都也有 chatbot 去幫大家手去improve 那個 backend 的 efficiency 啦，譬如一些最 straightforward 的問題，其實可以用個 chatbot 去幫你去 tick 咗佢，或者一些基本的 inquiry 啊，我想知道譬如我這個 order 的 delivery date， 個 tracking number 等等這些，怎樣去 enable 這件事發生，我們也有 solutions 可以幫到大家。咁我估即係成個喺 digital 嘅世界裏邊，喺 export 嘅經驗裏邊，其實好需要一啲 technology 去 back up 大家去做好依盤生意。咁Google Cloud 亦都有好多唔同嘅 ideas 可以 share 俾大家。咁如果有需要或者有一啲問題，或者你遇到一啲 challenge 喺 technology 咧，亦都可以放喺個 chatbot 度啦，chat room 嗰度啦，可以喺今日問啦，或者係你可以 fill in 翻個 feedback form。去俾我哋知道啊，其實你諗緊呢啲嘢喎，Google 有冇啲相關嘅方法可以幫到大家？好，咁咧雖然頭先好似講到結尾咁啊，我亦都想將一個比較新嘅 technology 去 share 俾各位嘅。如果大家知道咧 ，Google I/O 都係 Google 一年一度嘅盛事啦。咁喺呢個盛事嘅裏邊咧，其實我哋都cloud 裏邊亦都有一個solutions， 我覺得都好關乎成個 customer experience 嘅情況嘅。依個叫做 immersive stream for XR， 咩叫 XR 咧？就 extended reality 啦。咁如果靠近啲大家平常用嘅terminology 就 AR、VR 嘅 experience。我哋發覺咧，我哋亦都做咗一啲 research， 原來extended reality 係好幫到成個 customer journey。個 customer journey 亦都可以 convert into 一啲purchase。如果你睇翻右下角啦，紅色嗰啲 data 啦，其實如果有 AR 嘅 online retail 咧，其實11倍係一個11倍增長嘅spending behaviour。多啲人有11倍嘅 shopper 會 intend 有 tendency 去買嘢，亦都2.7倍會增加佢嘅時間去 shopping。咁依一個係一個好重要嘅元素，如果你留得住佢喺個 shopper 喺你嘅 site 度，其實亦都可以增加即係成個customer experience 同埋 conversion。咁點解依件事 AR VR 其實講好耐啦？咁有咩 significance？Google 想 invest 喺依一個 pillar 上邊咧？ 說穿了咧，到最尾就係一個 response time。如果你用一啲傳統嘅 AR VR 嘅 technology， 左邊紅色嗰、那個放喺你某一個嘅 server 或者某一個cloud technology 底下，其實可能 load 一個15 meg 嘅一個 VR 嘅 experience 咧，要超過30秒先 load 到出嚟。你諗下30秒可以做幾多嘢？30秒可以去咗好多個 website， 或者去到某一個 website 已經買完嘢，完成咗 transactions， 呢個好唔理想。但如果 leverage 即係喺 Google Cloud 嘅 technology 底下，其實我哋講緊1.5G 啦，唔係15 meg 啦已經。我哋可以用2 seconds 啦，兩秒之內已經可以 load 到個 content， 咁成個 experience 會好唔同。呢件事咧就雖然我哋啱啱 announce， 但係其實已經有唔同嘅 partner 同我哋去喺唔同嘅 industry 底下咧去做呢啲嘅AR VR 嘅 experience。賣車嘅有啦，賣廚房嘅用具有啦，有 KDDI 亦都係 shopping 嘅 experience 啦，或者 travel。咁所以依個亦都係展現緊一個Google 其實 make it very available 嘅一個extended reality 嘅 solution， 可以幫大家手去令到依件事容易啲，亦都可以快啲 deploy 到喺你哋個 site 上。有一個 wow effect 也好，有一個好好嘅 brand image 也好，或者好似 research 咁講，可以提供一個即係、better conversions 喺你哋個 website 上邊。咁呢啲都係啲重要嘅元素，希望幫到大家手喺你喺 export 嘅過程裏邊可以做得更好嘅成績啦。好，咁我嘅 content 咧到依度。如果大家頭先仲未填到有機會填呢個 feedback form 咧，依度都有個 QR code， 大家都可以填翻個。feedback form 啦，俾翻啲feedback 我哋，同埋有問題或者想我哋 contact 翻你的話咧，其實都可以透過依張 feedback form 咧去俾我哋知道嘅。好啦，咁就多謝大家先，睇下大家有冇問題啦。
好，唔該曬 Eunice。咁大家如果有問題想問咧，都可以喺個 chat room 度問啦。或者如果你想開麥講都亦都可以嘅。咁其實 OK， 有問題啦已經。
好 ，Do you mean that we can put our website into your Google Cloud？ 依個問題咧就係、如果你係 on 緊你個 website 啦，你當然可以即係 host 喺我哋 Google Cloud 上邊啦。咁依個第一啦，咁、那個 benefit 就可能係你可以 leverage 咗我哋個 global network 啦，頭先 mention 嘅。咁亦都譬如話係啦，即係依個係一個即係你可以做到嘅東西啦。好，等我睇下先啊。即係啦，個 response 其中一個 factor 即係我哋見到嘅其中一個好 significant 嘅 factor for website 嘅 performance 係個 network 係啦，因為如果講得直接啲咧，就係、如果你 leverage 嗰個 Google 嘅private network 的話，其實就好似你搭機鐵去機場咁樣，咁就一站咧就會去到你個 user 度。但如果你 leverage 其他嘅譬如你on premises 嘅一啲 server 或者其他 cloud provider 咧，咁好似就、那個經驗就要好似搭巴士啊，係啦，嗰啲嗰啲巴士咧去機場咁樣，咁就會站站停嘅，因為其實佢 go through 一個 internet 而唔係一個自己嘅網絡咯，咁所以係會有一個performance 嘅分別嘅。好，有冇其他問題咧？問翻頭先個 session 都得嘅喎，唔係一定係個 cloud。你突然之間諗起，原來我有第啲export 嘅問題。即管可以問你。好，有另一個問題就係、如果我個 website 唔係放 Google Cloud 上面啦，咁頭先講嘅 features 其實可唔可以用得到？其實可以嘅，因為其實依個係一個獨立嘅即係嘅功能嚟嘅。如果技術啲咁講，就其實 through 一個即係API 你就可以 call 到依一個，譬如點講嘅 search。嘅capability 啦，或者頭先講嘅recommendations 啦，或者係translation， 都可以好直接咁樣去用得到嘅，唔需要一定放喺 Google 上面嘅。
跟住仲有一個問題，點樣 join 呢個 Google 嘅 AI recommendations？
好，不如你留個資料俾我哋啦，喺個 feedback form 度，咁我哋之後再 reach out to 你。
好。好，大家仲有啲問題可以問阿 Eunice 啦，又或者之前阿 Adrian 或者 Adeline 嗰邊都仲有啲問題可以問翻嘅。咁如果可能再想了解多啲關於再 in depth 想了解多啲關於 Google 嘅一啲好 specific 嘅某一啲 solution 咧，咁大家都可以喺個 feedback form 度留翻個資料，咁佢哋咧就會有人 send 條信再聯絡大家嘅。又或者大家諗到啲咩問題，可能嚟緊 下兩個禮拜嗰啲 section 嘅時候都想知道嘅，嗰個 feedback form 都有啲位置可以俾大家留翻資料嘅。
如果某一啲 topics 你哋覺得我好想知道嘅，咁你就寫個 feedback form 度，睇下我哋可唔可以 accommodate 到呢啲 content 喺跟 section 度啦。
好，咁可能大家暫時都未有其他問題，或者三位 speaker 有冇其他嘢想補充咧？就住個 presentation 有啲嘢可能有嘢想補充嘅話，
應該佢哋兩個領頭。
好。OK。好。咁唔緊要，咁係啦，咁首先都再一次多謝今日 Google 三位代表嘅同我哋今日嘅分享啦。咁嚟緊我哋下個禮拜咧就會同你哋其他嘅一啲同事去見面啦。咁就係啦，如果大家咧對於頭先嘅分享提過嘅有一啲嘅 tools 咧，你哋想再深化啲去了解翻嘅話咧，其實下個禮拜嘅 section 咧都會幫到大家嘅。如果大家下個禮拜 section 未報名嘅話咧，而家喺個 chat room 度咧就已經有一條 register 嘅 link。咁大家可以歸入去咧，就可以報嚟緊嗰兩個 section 嘅時間。咁就同樣時間嘅星期四就同大家見面嘅。咁都係啲免費嘅 section。咁都希望喺嚟緊嗰兩個星期都會見到大家啦。好，咁就我哋稍後都有個 email follow up 翻俾大家，就係今日嘅Zoom 嘅一啲嘅 recording 嘅 share 啦。咁同埋就係個 feedback， 大家可以再留翻啲資料嘅聯絡俾我哋嘅。好。咁就如果大家冇問題，就今日我哋嘅 session 就差唔多完啦。好，咁我再一次多謝阿 Adrian 啦，多謝 Adeline 啦，同埋多謝阿 Eunice 嘅。好，
好多謝大家。
OK， 好啦，咁就多謝曬大家啦，唔該曬三位，咁我哋就下星期再同你哋 Google Team 嘅其他同事見面啦。OK， 唔該曬 ，Thank you，
拜拜，
拜拜，拜拜，拜拜。